No words can describe. Revelation is his design. His hand, his brush, his power, his paint. He works without rush. Indeed, he's never taint. From the fish of the sea to the deer of the wood, our God sees his creation and declares it to be good. Empty, unfinished, the artist looks over the shortage. Oh, he discovers. Let's make man in our image. His hand's careful, steady, patient, loving. He sees you, his creation, and says, wow, you're quite cunning. So he sets you apart in the garden of his glory, but then slithers a snake, invading your territory. His lips are poisoned, his words full of envy. Did God really say that fruit is deadly? God's prized creations look at one another in shame. Oh no, they cry, we sinned and we're to blame. The Creator looks at his people, the love of his life, now separated from the apples of his eye. So he sends his perfect son in a body like you and me to take our sin and shame and declare victory. Alas, he proclaims, there's hope for my love. On that tree, Christ died, covered in blood. But 3 days later, he comes back to life, victorious over the grave. And with arms open wide, he shouts, run into my grace. Our relationship restored, our hope resurrected. Humanity and divinity once again intersected. His love as rapid as the waters, his plan as adventurous as Mount Everest. Our father, our dad, looks into the eyes of his children and says, your life isn't finished.